Welcome to the Inner Voice. This is Pastor Tech of the Friends of Jesus Christ Canada. Friends, the Bible tells us that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. And so today, again, let's study some scriptures. These are familiar scriptures, but we need this for us to be able to gain more faith in God. Well, this past Christmas, we talk about peace, you know, that peace on earth, goodwill to men. And so we are living in a troubled world. But how can we really have peace? See, it depends on who the God that we are serving. Tonight, our topic is love and forgiveness. Our faith, the Christian faith, is different from all other faith because of this too. Love and forgiveness. Our God is a loving God, and He is a forgiving God. I don't see any other gods out there that have the same attributes, that they are loving and they are forgiving. So if they are not loving and forgiving, can we expect peace from them? Because if there is no love, what is in them? Hatred, anger, bitterness, all kinds of problems, those will reign in their hearts. And so there will be chaos, there will be infighting, there will be trouble in the world that we are living, because the God that they are serving does not teach how to love and how to forgive. But our God teaches us how to love and to forgive. And so that's what we shall learn today. Let's study it and let's learn from it. And you know what, friends? If their God does not know how to love and to forgive, they will not learn also how to love and forgive. But if our God loves us and forgives us, and then we shall also receive the same Spirit that we can also love and forgive. And so I pray that tonight we can learn some lessons out of this topic. And so stay tuned, don't go, we'll come back. Welcome back to the Inner Voice. As I mentioned earlier, let's try to learn how to love and how to forgive. And so let's start with a verse that is so familiar to us, you can practically memorize it, and that is John 3:16. And this is God's love. And we are told that for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, so that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. So this is God's love. So He manifested His love. So when you love, you give. So He gave His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And so that is how God demonstrated His love. In Romans 5:8, we are told here, but God demonstrated His own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. So He had the provision. God had the provision. He knew that we will fail. He knew when He created that, He created that, created us perfect, a loving person, a forgiving person. But somehow along the way, we will fall. And He already knew that even from the beginning. So He provided, He made the way. And so we are told now that God demonstrated His love towards us in this, when we were yet sinners. Nung makasalanan pa tayo, namatay na si Kristo. So alam ng Panginoon na we will fail, na hindi tayo perfectong tao. But that is love. That is God's love. And so He did not allow us to perish. He did not allow us to be embroiled in all kinds of trouble here on earth. But He wanted us that we receive good life, eternal life. And so that's how He demonstrated. He gave His Son. And so, as I said earlier, that if this is the kind of God that we are serving, then we can also love, because we are just imitating what He's doing. Supposing a father is a hateful man, he does not know how to love. Do you think that the children will be able to love also? No. This is what we call like father, like son. So in the same manner, if God is loving, because we are called children of the living God, we should also be loving. Amen. And if we are able to love, then we can live peacefully. We can live at peace with one another because we are living in love. Now, this is a sacrificial love that God demonstrated. And so we should also love sacrificially. We don't see the errors, the sins of others. You know, when someone offends us, we don't magnify the offense. We look at them with love because love is the act of the will. Amen. You purpose it to love. You decided to love regardless of who the person is. Yung iba nga, hindi ka mahal-mahal eh. Makita mo pa lang, inis ka na eh, di ba? Pero ang sabi ng Panginoon sa atin dito is mahalin mo. Ano? Kahit na yung mga taong hindi ka mahal-mahal dyan, mahalin mo. So, ganun ang gusto ng Panginoon sa atin. And God also is a forgiving God. 1 John 1:9. In 1 John 1:9, we are told here that if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all our unrighteousness. And so God is a forgiving God. But the thing here is, He just don't forgive us without us asking for it. That's why we are told to ask, confess, and then He will forgive. And so, again, friends, He also have a provision for us again. When we sin, we can always go to Him and ask for forgiveness. And He is faithful. We are told that He is faithful, He is just, and He will forgive us our sins. And so, when God loves each one of us, friends, He is manifesting His nature. In Psalm 86, verse 15, this is how the psalmist described God. Psalm 86, verse 15. But you, O Lord, are a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness. This is our God. Amen. And because this is our God, then we can live in safety. Because He is faithful, then we can enjoy our lives. He is compassionate. He is gracious. Friends, let us be like God in the way that we love one another. Then if we love the way that God loves each one of us, then we can have peace. But as I said earlier, if other gods don't teach this way, then what can we expect but trouble? Because if they don't teach these gods don't teach love, don't teach forgiveness, then how can we expect others to love us and to forgive us? And so that's why we have to pray for everybody else, that they may come to know the true and the living God, ang tunay na Diyos ay nagmamahal, ang tunay Diyos ay nagpapatawad. Kung meron tayong Diyos na kikita dyan, naririnig dyan, na hindi marunong magmahal, kundi puro ang gawain dito is magparusa lang, ano, ang gawin dito sa mag-utos pumatay, eh, anong asahan natin na kapayapaan sa ating kalagitnaan? Wala. Kaya ang panalangin natin dito is panalangin natin ang buong mundo, lahat ng tao, na marunong silang magmahal at matutuhan nilang magmahal kung meron silang Diyos na tulad natin ating Diyos. Amen. And so friends, this is love and forgiveness. So let us try to learn how to love and to forgive. I think this is key to us living an abundant life, a fruitful life, a peaceful life. A lot of people want to live this kind of a life, but they don't love. How can you expect others to love you back? Because again, in loving them, we shall also be loved back. In forgiving them, we shall also be forgiven. And so our God teaches us how to love and to forgive. And so, Let us not live in anger and bitterness, hatred and all kinds of negative attitude. Let us love with the kind of love that He gave us. And so I pray, friends, that in the next portion, let's try to apply it in a very personal way, that we can truly live the way that God wants us to live, living in peace. Remember that God is compassionate, He is loving, abounding in love and faithfulness. So again, let's have a break, but don't go. We'll come back. Welcome back to The Inner Voice. As I mentioned earlier, like Father, like Son. And so just as God loves us, we should also love others. And so if we go to John 15, verse 12 to 13, my command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that he lay down his life for a friend. And so this is how the Lord wants us now to love. He said that as I have loved you, love one another. So the basis now is God's love. He set a standard. So we cannot go below that standard. He said that, no, this is the standard that I set. So love one another as I have loved you. Now, this love is sacrificial because he said that greater love has no one than this, that he laid down his life for his friends. So we should be willing to lay down our lives for our friends. So it's really sacrificial. Are we willing to die for our friends? In the case of the Lord Jesus Christ, he died for us. He calls us his friends. And so he died for us willingly because of love. In the name of love, he died for us. And so same thing, friends, he expects us to love each other. And of course, he also expects us to forgive others the way that he had forgiven us. That's why in Matthew 6, 14, in Matthew 6, verse 14 to 15, for if you forgive men when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you don't forgive them their sins, your Father will not forgive your sin also. And so we are told here that we also forgive the way that the Father had forgiven us. Because if we don't forgive, we shall not be forgiven. Very critical, very critical. Again, he gave us that measure, the measure of forgiveness. What is the extent of our forgiveness? The Bible tells us that, you know, when God forgives, as far as the east is from the west, he forgave our sins. So, can you measure that? Maybe north and south, you can measure it because it loops after that. But east and west, for as long as you're walking, it's immeasurable. And so what we are saying, friends, is that we have to forgive others also. Now, in verse 12 of that chapter 16, he said, this is now part of the prayer, our Father, the prayer. He said, forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. Just as we have forgiven. So if we forgive much, or if we have been forgiven much, then we should forgive much also. But if we don't forgive, we shall only be forgiven to that extent that we have forgiven others. You know, there is this parable, the parable of the unmerciful servant that is in Matthew 18, from verse 32, if you read that. That parable, it says that, you know, there is this servant that was forgiven by the master. Well, he owed a lot, but he pleaded for mercy. And the master forgave him. He was released from prison. And now comes someone that had owed this person, the one that was forgiven. So the other, you know, the first one, he owed his master a lot, but the master forgave him. Now, when he was forgiven, he looked around, he turned around and saw someone that owed him something, a small amount. Now he went after him, and because the person could not pay back, so he sent him in jail. And then the master came to know about this. Sabi niya, I have forgiven you much. And you cannot forgive those who also owed you only few bucks. Kaya sabi dito, no, you have to go back to prison. Mga kapatid, ang ang paraan ng Panginoon ganito, kung tayo napatawad niya, tayo magpatawad din. Tulad dun sa kwentong yun, malaki ang utang ng isa, napatawad siya. Pero hindi niya mapatawad yung nakautang sa kanya. Maliit na bagay lamang. And so, we have to forgive. Let us love each other and let us forgive one another. These two should go together. Again, forgiveness is an act of the will. It's an act of the will. You have to forgive. See, someone had offended you. Siguro, sinumpa mo na yan. Ano, kung isusumpa mo na yan. Pero ang utos sa atin is patawarin mo siya. Hindi ka magtatanim. Kasi wala namang ibang mag-aani nung sama ng loob, kundi ikaw din. Di ba? Yung isang kinainisan mo, kuminsan, naku, ang sarap ng kain. Ano, ikaw nandito ka, nakita mo siya, galit na galit ka, hindi ka makakain, hindi ka natutunawan, dahil galit ka doon sa tao. Pero yung taong kinakagalitan mo, tuwang-tuwa kung makain siya, samantalang ikaw, naghihirap. Di mo na lang patawarin, di ba? Di magsaya kayo, magkaroon kayo ng feasting, magkainan kayong dalawa, magbatian kayo, edi masarap ang buhay. Di ba ganon? So, ang gusto utos ng Panginoon sa atin is mahalin natin kahit na hindi makamahal-mahal. Pangit man yan, maganda sa tingin ng Panginoon yan. Ang ibig ko sabihin, pangit ang ugali. Ano? Mapupunaan niya ng pagmamahal. Ngayon, ganun din. Kung pinairal mong hindi pagpapatawad, ikaw din ang magdudusa. Ikaw din mahihirapan. So, bakit ka pa maghihirap? Magpatawad ka na lang, masaya ka pa, maging bata ka pa. Hindi ba? Alalahanin natin, sabi ng Bible, a cheerful heart is a good medicine. Mga kapatid, a cheerful heart is a good medicine. Nakakapagpabata yon, kasi walang tinatanim na galit sa loob. Masaya, nagmamahal, nagpapatawad. And so our prayer today is that let's love one another. Amen. Just as God loves us, then we have to love others too. Sacrificially, we are told to lay down our lives for a friend. So are we willing to lay down our lives for a friend? Are we willing to love somebody that he had really offended us? Friends, if we want to enjoy life, let's love them. Let's forgive them in the way that God loves us. You know, if we look at ourselves, I don't think that we are deserving of God's love. With the things that we have done, lahat ng nagawa natin na masasama, sa tingin ko hindi tayo karapat dapat na mahalin din ng Diyos. Pero ganun din ang pagmamahal ng Panginoon sa atin. He loved us so much that He forgave us. And so, same thing, friends. Let us also love them. Let's forgive them. Let's not keep a record of wrong. Rather, let's overlook their transgressions. Let's overlook their sins. And let love prevails. So, I pray that each one of us, again, we are still in the New Year spirit. Let's start this year loving and forgiving one another. So I pray, friends, that you too, just consider what you are doing in your life. Tingnan natin ano nasa puso natin. Meron ba tayong hinanakit? Magpatawad tayo. Maabot natin ang ending ng year na ito ng masaya kung meron tayong pagmamahal at may pagpapatawaran. And so, again, friends, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the still small voice of the Lord. And so, the Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord will make His face shine upon you and give you His peace, His shalom. And if you need to contact me, again, my email address is here, and our address here in the church is here also, and our website is friendsofjesuschrist.com. God bless.